There are many times when I am out in wetlands that I feel a great degree of satisfaction and a peacefulness, a oneness when I'm in those areas, that I know that they're special and I know that they're important. I grew up in a small rural town, so I got to spend a lot of time outside, climbing trees, picking berries, and swimming in the river. I'm Mary Kentula, and I'm an ecologist, and I work for the U.S. Environmental Protection Agency at its research lab in Corvallis, Oregon. I am the technical lead for the National Wetland Condition Assessment. And the National Wetland Condition Assessment is one of the National Aquatic Resource Surveys that are done by EPA every year. Wetlands are areas that are transitional between aquatic and uplands. Wetlands are very much known for their improvement of water quality. They tend to be high in organic matter, and those types of soils are good at holding on to contaminants. The wetlands also are places where unique plants grow that don't occur in the aquatic environment or the terrestrial environment. And because of that, many wetlands are very diverse, and that diversity in plants means you also have a diversity in animals. And so they're important for maintaining our biodiversity in the landscape. And that's why it's important that we understand them and protect them. Research of my team was used to formulate policy at the national level, and it's also been used by various states. And that's a real thrill to see science used in that way to support good decision making. I think there is a need for people to maintain a connection with their environment, and in particular to learn about wetlands. And I'm thinking about how easy it is to be in a building all day long in front of a screen of some sort and not to venture out anywhere and know anything but that electronic world. I think we really have an impoverished life if we don't get out and learn more about what's beyond the buildings we live and work in.